Hello dear learners and viewers, welcome to you all. Hope you are going on well with your studies. Today I shall talk about the story of a great hero in Greek and Roman mythology. Okay, the hero is very famous for his bravery and adventure. Okay, before starting our session, let me show you some pictures. Okay, now can you guess whose pictures are these? Okay, you see? These are the pictures of Hercules or Heracles. In Greek mythology, the hero is called Heracles, and in Roman mythology, he is called Hercules. Okay, and this topic has been taken from your English for Today, Unit 9, Lesson 4. But if you have a copy of New Edition, you will get it Unit 14, Lesson 4. Okay, the term Hercules is the Latin form of Greek Heracles, meaning glory of Hera. Now let me talk about Hercules' family tree. Here you see Jupiter or Zeus, the king of all gods and goddesses. In Roman mythology he is called Jupiter, but in Greek mythology he is called Zeus. Then Alcmena, a mortal woman, she had a husband whose name is Amphitryon. He is the Theban general. Now you see Hercules is the son of Zeus and Alcmena. That means Hercules is a demigod because his father is a god and his mother is a mortal human being. Okay, and now see his siblings. Siblings, first of all you see Epicles. Okay, Epicles is his half brother, son of Alcmena and Amphitryon. Then Apollo, his half brother, he is the son of Jupiter and Hera, or Zeus or Hera you can say. And Ares, the god of war, son of Zeus and Hera. Okay, now it is very interesting and important that the story of Hercules starts before the hero, before Hercules was born. And you see, Zeus or Jupiter is known to slip out of his home on Mount Olympia to seduce nymphs or other mortal women, sometimes with or without their consent. And Hera, wife of Zeus and also the queen of all gods and goddesses, was jealous and vengeful towards her husband's many mistresses and illegitimate children. Okay, now you see in the course of the event, Amphitryon, husband of Alcmena, for his expedition against Typhians and Telebones, the inhabitants of Typhos, situated in the northwest of Greece, went there, and during that period, Zeus disguised himself as Amphitryon and persuaded Alcmena that he was her husband. Then, extending one night into three, Zeus slept with Alcmena, thereby Alcmena became pregnant. Okay, and when Amphitryon returned to Thebes, Alcmena told Amphitryon that he had come before the night and slept with her. And later Amphitryon came to know the fact through Tiresias, the priest of Delphi, what Zeus had done. Okay, and as a result, when Hercules was born, Alcmena and Amphitryon named the baby as Hercules, meaning the glorious gift of Hera. And on the other hand, you see Zeus, knowing that Alcmena was going to give birth a child, Zeus had bragged that one of his descendants was going to be born who would rule the two mighty kingdoms, Mycenae and Tiryns. Now here again, Hera played a trick with Zeus, and he and she made Zeus a promise that the first son would be the king. And now, using her power, Hera retarded Alcmena's delivery. And in the meantime, Eurystheus, the great grandson of Zeus, was born, and with the help of Hera, or with the favor, getting the favor of Hera, he became the ruler of Mycenae and Tiryns, which actually Zeus had intended for Hercules. Okay. Now here you see in the Hera, who is very zealous and vengeful of Zeus's illegitimate child or mistresses, she tried to devastate, tried to kill Hercules from the very childhood of Hercules. Okay, so when Hercules was a child, she sent two snakes to strangle Hercules in his sleep. But here we should remember that Hercules is the son of Jupiter, the kings of all gods and goddesses. Naturally, he was very powerful, he was fearless, and we see that when the snakes came, Hercules grabbed the snakes by the neck and strangled the snake before they were about to strike. Okay, and later Hercules married Megara and lived happily with his three children, but the vengeful Hera, or the the Hera didn't stop here. She wanted to devastate Hercules's life, so she planned a evil plan, and using her power, she made Hercules mad, and Hercules became insane with rage, and then he killed his wife and three children mercilessly, gruesomely killed them. And even worse, that Hercules didn't understand that he killed his wife and three children. But when Hercules became calm and quiet, then he realized what a heinous crime he has committed. Then with broken heart, he had realized that his life had been destroyed, and then he set out to seek punishment to atone for the heinous crime he had committed. So he traveled to Delphi, to Delphi temple, to ask Apollo what he should do to get rid of his soul of this evil. Okay, then Apollo told him that he should undergo long and severe punishment. He should do a very hard, laborious task, and thus he might atone for his crime. Okay, then he sent Hercules to Eurystheus, a very cruel king, for 12 years, and Apollo told him that told Hercules that he had to complete 12 difficult or 12 laborious tasks to get rid of his sin. And these 12 labors are known as 12 labor of Hercules in Greek and Roman mythology. Okay, then Apollo also promised Hercules that after he had completed all his tasks, his soul will be cleansed of sin, and he would be able to join gods and goddesses on Mount Olympia. Okay, these are the prehistory. Okay, prehistory of the text that you are going to read in your English for today. Okay, now before going to start that session, let us see the 12 labors that Hercules completed to fulfill Apollo's wishes. The first one, the slaying of the Nemean lion whose skin he thereafter wore. The second one, the slaying of the 9-headed Hydra of Lerna. Third one, the capture of the elusive hind of Arcadia. Fourth, the capture of the wild boar of Mount Erymanthias. Fifth, the cleansing of in a single day of the cattle stable of King Augeas of Elis. Number six, the shooting of the monstrous man-eating birds of the Stamphalian marshes. Number seven, the capture of the mad bull that terrorized the island of Crete. Number eight, the capture of the man-eating mares of King Diomedes of the Bistones. Number nine, the taking of the girdle of Hippolyta, the queen of the Amazon. Number 10, the seizing of the cattle of the three-bodied giant Geryon, who ruled the island of Erythia. Number 11, the bringing back of the golden apples kept at the world's end by the Hesperides. Number 12, the phasing up from the underworld of the triple-headed dog Cerberus, guardian of its gate. Okay, these are the 12 labors of Hercules. Now let's start from the text. Hercules, in the first text, you see that the first task involved a fight with a lion, the valley of Nemea. Okay, in the valley of Nemea, the people were disturbed by a terrible lion. So Eurystheus ordered Hercules to kill the lion, and at first Hercules tried to killed the lion with his arrow and club, but later he changed his trick and he killed the lion with his power, with his strength. Okay, and victorious, he returned to the Mycenae carrying the dead lion on his shoulder, a sight that terrified the king. And this is very important. After killing the lion, he carried the dead body of the lion on his shoulder. And seeing this scenery, the king Eurystheus became very terrified. And here you see the picture of slaying the Nemean lion, and you see Hercules is carrying the dead body of the lion on his shoulder. Now, this one is the second task. His second task was to slay the monster called Hydra that was ravaging the country of Argos. The Hydra had 9 heads, of which one was immortal, and our hero struck off its head with his club. But whenever he knocked off a head, 2 new ones erupted in its place. So the task was difficult, and eventually, with the help of his devoted servant Iola, Hercules succeeded in burning all the heads except the 9th one, and he decided to bury it under a huge rock. In other words, Hercules triumphed again, as he would every time he was given impossible task by Eurystheus. In this way, you see, Hercules successfully completed 12 labors that was assigned by Eurystheus. And this is how he began to acquire the reputation of a hero possessing immense strength throughout the world. And now here you see the picture of slaying the Hydra by Hercules. So these 2 tasks have been described in your text, but remember, it is very, very often this question comes in the university admission test, how many tasks Hercules has to do. Okay, Hercules had to complete 12 difficult task, known as 12 labors of Hercules. Okay, now dear students, based on your understanding the text, now you have to say whether the statement is true or false. Okay, number one, Hercules decided to accomplish impossible task because he wanted to be a hero. Is it true or false? Of course it is false, because Hercules did all this task not to be a hero, rather he was assigned to do the task, and going to do the task he naturally became hero. The king was impressed when he saw Hercules after his first victory. Not at all. False. The king, instead of being impressed, the king became terrified to see it. Hercules managed to defeat Hydra entirely on his own. This is also false, because we know that Hercules was successful in doing the task with the help of his devoted servant Iola. Number 4. Hercules ended up bearing all parts of Hydra. This is also false. No. Hercules buried only the immortal part of the Hydra. Every time he was given an impossible task, Hercules succeeded in doing it. Yes, this is true. So, that is all for today. Hope you have understood. And now, it is your duty to read the text sincerely. So, thank you all. Bye.